ओके सो हाय पलक, हाउ आर यू?
हाय हाय सर, आई एम गुड, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम वेरी फाइन. ओके सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वांट टू थैंक यू फॉर फाइंडिंग टाइम, बिकॉज आई नो यू हैव अ रियली बिजी शेड्यूल. यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर अपकमिंग पैरालंपिक गेम्स, सो यू मस्ट बी रियली बिजी. एंड इट्स रियली आई एम रियली ग्रेटफुल दैट यू फाउंड टाइम आउट ऑफ योर प्रैक्टिस. एंड you are the youngest para badminton player to qualify from India. So like, is there any pressure on you, or like how are you feeling about that fact?
Well, Paralympics and Olympics is a dream for everyone.
Yeah.
And me having that vision and achieving that, it's a great thing for me. And I would say it's a pressure. It's the in this situation, I don't feel much pressured as well. Like, if you want to feel pressure, it's up to you.
Yeah.
Like every. And has something positive and negative to go up with. So I rather take this as an opportunity to have set higher goals in my career. And I see for the upcoming Tokyo Paralympics to make my nation proud.
That was a really mature statement by you. Palak, must say I'm not feeling like I'm interviewing some like a school or college girl. I'm feeling like I'm interviewing a really matured player of India. So, Palak, I've been reading quite a lot about you on internet and in newspaper. So, could you share your journey with our listeners? That how was your journey was, and is there any role model which you look to for your motivation?
Okay. Well, talking about my journey, I would say I didn't choose badminton, rather it chose me, because badminton in my life, it came as a blessing.
Okay.
So we are in the field of sports where I thought of being an athlete as a professional level and representing the nation. It was nowhere in my mind, I would say. It just happened, and it's all started in there was a small incident that happened in my life, and that really changed me from what I was at that time and what I am today and what I'm looking forward in my life, I would say. One day, it was, I think so in 2016, I was coming out of a mall with my mother and my brother, and on the way to our car, I met a person. He just asked me like, what has happened to your arm? So I was very familiar with question, because before learning, as soon as I entered to school and to the society, before learning the English, the education and everything, I learned one word, that was by birth. So my parents, my family, they taught me whenever somebody's asked you what has happened to your arm, I was not knowing the meaning of it, but I used to say it's by birth. About my reply, I told him that it's by birth, and then he was like, do you know what is para sports, and do you know what is para badminton and all? SSA para sports bhi hota hai. So you are quite young, and if you will start out with this, you can do something great. So for my mother also, it was very surprising, because for the first time we heard this word para sports. And then he specifically told about badminton, and he specifically told about him. And he told me that you start out with this sport and you can excel to great heights. So you should try that. So I was also like, but so he just asked me about, I was like, okay. Then my mother also, she took the contact of him, and she wrote it on the paper, and then he went his own way, and so did we. For us, my parents tried to push me, because they wanted me to do something, and then they told me that you can start up with this and you can just have a try about it. But I didn't took that thing very seriously, and I was like, ki, okay, itne log milte hain, why you are taking that seriously? So then this topic got closed for a couple of months, and there was an incident in my school where we were going for a handball trial, and at that moment we were standing in a queue, and teacher was explaining us the sport as it was newly introduced. And we didn't even started playing that, my teacher called me aside and she said me that Palak, it's better you concentrate upon your studies. If you will play, you will hurt yourself more and then you won't be able to do anything. So it's better you concentrate upon that. There are some handicap quotas for the handicapped persons. With the help of it, you can further get a good degree and a good job. So you concentrate upon that. So at that moment, I felt very disappointed and I was, first of all, I felt bad for myself. I thought that why God has done that to me and why every time I have to face such things of society and with all in every field of sports, and if I wish to do something and everyone is like, either they are betraying me, they are ignoring me, or now they are saying in front of my face only. For previously, I used to hear backbiting from the teachers and other students. But this time when I heard, I just thought of that incident and I thought to just give it up a try. And if the things go well and if that's the way for me, it would be something that will be really very great for me and that can change the thinking of all the society. And especially for the thinking that people have for disabled persons that they cannot be in sports. So I went back to my home. I told my parents that I wish to try that sport. They were very surprised and they didn't even took me seriously. Then I kept on saying, so then they were like, okay. And they were very surprised at how it happened and all. Although I never share that these things happen in school because I used to feel that they are so close to me and they are so attached with me. If I will get emotional regarding this, so it will also give a very bad impact to them. So I never shared these things with them. So I was like, I wish to try. Then when I kept on insisting, my father, he took me seriously. And then they tried getting in touch again with that person. And then when he got in touch with, you know, that person was none other than Gaurav Saroli, whom I met in 2016. So we were like, this world is so round that you never know which thing was meant for you. And then I made up my mind, and that very coming weekend, my father made a plan and I came to Lucknow. And since then, from holding up of a racket and to where I am is a journey that started with that small incident and that made me think differently, do different things, and moreover, to aim for a better thing in my life. Had it not been badminton, I don't know which part of degree, which part of education I would have been pursuing. So then I came here, they left me over here, and then I started up with my trainings and all. And then sir made small targets for me. First of all, I started in 2017, and in 2018, there were nationals in Varanasi. Varanasi is to Lucknow, and I was very excited that I will be playing my first nationals and then I'll go back to school and I'll tell everybody about it and I'll share my experience. But unfortunately, sir didn't allow me to go for that nationals. I was very disappointed, but he was like, no, it's not the right time for you to come out. You just concentrate upon your practice, and when it will be the right moment, I'll just let you know and then you will participate. So my parents also trusted and left everything on sir only, that when sir will say, then only we will let you in for your first tournament. And then in 2019, I was happy. He told me that now it's the right time for you to come out. And then I played my first nationals and I became the national champion of juniors, seniors, women doubles, all three categories. And I got second runner up in mixed doubles. And then I was happy. I shared when I was so excited and I showed sir that the target which he aimed for me, I have fulfilled that. But that time he was happy. He said, he smiled and he said that I have next target ready for you. And that was to qualify for Paralympics. And then I started in my journey of playing international tournaments. And at that time, as I was very new to the tournaments, I didn't have any sponsors. So the Asian countries one Asian country tournaments will be lesser amount than the European ones. So we made a plan. We missed a couple of tournaments, and then we just decided, and then the supporters also came. I'm being supported by Wellspun, and that's helping me in all my training purpose and everything. And now also being qualified for Paralympics, I'm also part of TOPS. So that's how it all started, and all the targets, all the aims are coming a long ways, and that keep us motivated towards our goals and to just sweat harder the next day.
So that was so great to hear it. So earlier you mentioned that so first time Gaurav sir just mentioned the term para sports, or like para badminton. Your family was not aware of it, or moreover you were not aware of it. So do you believe that there's a gap between like the information which is spread out on these topics and the amount that players know about it? Because I'm sure that there must be a lot of players who would be interested in sports, right, in para sports, but do you think that they're not getting ample information on this subject?
For this subject, I think India is developing, definitely. There is a lot of awareness about sports as of now, because being preparing for Paralympics, SAI is also helping a lot for the camps and everything, and that's been covered by social media a lot, and people are also getting very high tech on social media. So I think definitely the medium and the platform of spread of the sports and spread up of the categories, and about there is para sports, or there is able body badminton, there is deaf badminton, so the awareness is spreading. And across, I believe that more advancements will also take place, as now we are also if we talk specific about para badminton, I would be very happy to share that we have a first para badminton academy here in Lucknow, which is dedicated to all the para players. Despite the lockdown, we are here living up in a Omic city colony, and here inside the colony we have taken 2-3 houses, one for juniors, one for seniors, and one in which the girls stay, and I'm living in a PG. And so the whole setup being construct, and here only in the colony itself we have our academy. So for us, we are the first citizens. It's our home. Because before, whenever we used to go for training, we used to go to BBD, we used to go to sports college, we used to go to LDA courts, and we were used to get those slots at which time the able-bodied players have finished their training. So their timings were priority. So if we have to go tomorrow to play, our timings were very specific. From at that also the mid-afternoon timings. From 11 to 2, like this. But now the things have changed, and now everything depends upon us. We play up till 10 in the at night, whenever we wish to, on the games day and everything, whenever we get some liberty. Definitely.
Do you have any role model as well, which you look upon?
Talking about role models, I have, I admire a lot of people in my life, in which I think everyone is not perfect, but everyone has something unique in them. And I wish to get that some of the qualities which I like from those persons in me to develop myself and to become a good human being, definitely. If you talk specifically, I would say I admire Carolina Marin a lot. I love the way she roars on the court. I love the way she plays and everything she does. Her comeback last year when I had my injury, I used to watch up to her, how she recovered from her injury. And that also gave me the confidence and the energy to come up to invest my energy upon my positive things, and that can make me something good, and I can recover better from the injury. And also, I got a sir, because I like the thing, sir has brought me up to this sport, and being with him, I have learned a lot of things. Whenever on the way, wherever he finds anybody who is of who is disabled or anything, he always helps, and he always creates awareness about the sport, and that's indeed a great thing. And his knowledge and everything, the way he plans the things, that is something that that are very impressive, and I admire those things as well.
Okay, so for our listeners who must be interested in para sports or moreover para badminton, could you just tell more about Gaurav sir? Because actually we also requested him to join, but unfortunately he didn't have much time. So you could just tell about him, where to contact him, and about your new academy which you were telling about, that you have settled in your new academy. So any listener who is interested in para badminton, you could just reach out to him or at the academy, right? So you could just explain a bit.
The academy is here in Lucknow in Omic City, near Bijnor Road, and the academy is set up by the name Gaurav Connect Senior Badminton Academy.
Okay.
And Gaurav sir is the head national coach of Indian para badminton team, and he is the one who has, since last 4 years, he is the one who has brought so many laurels for our nation. And now I think so, para badminton has reached to a good height in terms of players getting Arjuna Award, and he himself is a Dronacharya awardee. And to get in touch with sir, you can check on the Google. You can contact through Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. And definitely, these are the ways you can get in touch with him. And if any queries, if anything that you, any contact, anything you want to get in para sports, you can also text me on Instagram, Twitter, or Facebook, on any of the social media handles. And I would be happy to help you up.
Okay, so for our listeners who are interested in para badminton, I'll surely suggest them to check out Gaurav Khanna sir's Instagram account and also Palak Kohli's Instagram account. You could just drop them a message, and I'm sure that they would be really happy to help. Okay, so Palak, moving on, you mentioned about COVID, those lockdown times. So could you just tell us more about that? How did you manage your training? And because your new academy must have been closed because of the lockdown, so how did you manage to just play and keep fit? And what was the mindset like?
Basically, talking about the last year, I would say the last year lockdown, when the COVID was newly introduced everywhere. For just hearing about the COVID pandemic all over the world, and then hearing about the postpone of the Paralympics, it was in a way a very big blow for me, because for the to qualify for Paralympics, I have sacrificed a lot of things. Specifically, I dropped my board exam, 12th board examinations, to qualify for Peru and Brazil tournaments. That were the two Paralympic qualification events that held in February last year. For me, then hearing about this, it was like I dropped my 1 year as well, and I didn't got this year Paralympics as well. So it was a zero period for me. I got a bit disappointed as well, because since the time I started playing badminton, I would say in a year, it's maximum, I would say 20 to 25 days that I spend at my home. Okay. And rest every time I'm here in Lucknow only. So then the things were like, it was an off season as well. But to keep ourselves motivated, as I was lucky that I was here in Lucknow, what we did was we made an outdoor court in our garden, and we used to do our training there. So there were a lot of challenges. As badminton being an indoor sport, is very difficult to play outdoors. Yeah. There was a lot of air, there was a lot of grass, mud, and the court was very slippery at times. But having Gaurav sir with us, he always had a plan A, B, C, depending upon the circumstances and the situation. So we were lucky to be here and to have him with us. So we worked a lot upon our skills and everything. And now when we are back on courts, we don't even feel any air. So it's like getting habituated to that thing. And I still remember last year when there was a lockdown, when we had to play in the gardens. So at that moment, we every night we used to pray that kal barish na hoye. Because whenever it rained, the whole court was so slippery and the water used to fill up there. And we were like, oh shit. So we were very sad, and every night we were just thinking ki bas barish na hoye. Talking about now, the courts, though there is a lockdown everywhere, so we as the academy is here only, and it's specific basically for para athletes only. We staying here, we at times make out to go to, we are doing our training because we are the first citizens over there. So it's closed for everybody except for us.
Okay.
So we keep together, and we are the only ones who go and train.
So, Palak, to add to your point, which you said that you had to improvise and just put nets in a park or a garden and just play in outdoors. So I want to add a point for our listeners that one day before yesterday, we were in a conversation with Rahul Bhardwaj. He's a badminton player as well. So he also mentioned a kind of similar thing that during lockdown, instead of just sitting back and just thinking like that you don't have anything to do, he just improvised and he just trained his upper body. Like he said that his smashes were really weak, so he had to improve his smashes and attacking game. So he just did strength training for his upper body, which he was neglecting during the other days. So maybe we could just based on your point as well, we could suggest to our listeners that instead of just sitting back, do something, like, right, you could just train, or like train your fitness, do your fitness, do anything, do any kind sorts of fitness, physical fitness thing. So don't just sit back, so that after you just get back on court, you feel like you have completely forgotten the game.
Yeah, also I would like to add upon, I would say after the last year pandemic, we had our first tournament in Dubai this year. So I would say that the lockdown period has helped me a lot, I would say. Like in a way, it was a blessing for me. Though I was sad that Paralympics had postponed and I dropped my examinations, but I had one positive thing as well, because I would be the youngest one to qualify for the games, I got one more year to prepare for Paralympics.
Yeah.
That was energy that kept us motivating to stay away from the family as well and to focus upon the training. And I was going through an injury. It was in a way blessing for me to recover from it as well. And so we worked upon a lot of skills, and I think so that skills and that hard work has paid me off in my singles in Dubai tournament, where I won a silver medal. And where I won triple medals, silver in women's singles and bronze in mixed doubles and bronze in women doubles as well. So I would say that period was a blessing for me, because after the injury, after 2 years, I played my first singles in a international or in a tournament, I would say.
So yeah, I'll just like to conclude it quickly with a point that either you could just treat it like a problem, or you could just like treat it as an opportunity, right? That as you said that you just improved on it, and you just thought of it like you are just you are just because you are youngest qualified badminton player for Paralympics, so you could just use that time to improve more, right? So yeah, so moving on, so Palak, that's a bit of personal question, and it's just completely up to you if you want to answer that. I want to ask, is there any strategy in your mind for Paralympics which you want to tell, that specific any specific strategy which you are following so that you could just win a medal?
Basically, all these strategies, all these skills and everything is planned by Gaurav Saroli. And we have a planning for it. And that is first that I have to stay injury free. And I'm focusing upon my strengthening a lot at this particular moment. And further, whenever I play on court, I have quality sessions. And I hope for having sessions which are specific on strokes, and that is the thing that will help me more to and will bring me closer towards getting there up on the podium, because I would be experiencing world top players who have consistently gained their rank and have a and they are far higher than me in terms of experience, in terms of their career, and in terms also in terms of their maturity. Few targets, but I'm happy to share that I have crossed a few of these targets already. Mm-hmm. And some of them looks a little blur right now, but I think so my focus and I think so the strategies and I think so the plannings and the implementation definitely and the actions will make me up towards to reach that goals. So I'm confident and I'm looking forward towards it.
Okay, so quickly, Palak, to conclude this point, what three qualities would you suggest that a badminton player should definitely have to achieve great success in his career?
Well, first of all, I would say an athlete should first become a good human being. This thing was taught to me by Gaurav sir, and I think so if we become a good human being, all the things will come up to our way. And second is we just need to be positive, and we need to be alert to grab the opportunities that can change and turn our life to some another mode. And the third thing is I would like to say to all the female players that don't be a bichari in your life. See what you have in you, because I would say everyone has something, some talent in them. So if you choose up with a coach, choose it with confidence, because when you will be confident, the goals will come up to your mind and the response to you. Because I would be like, when I was in my school, from the school where from where I heard that sports is not meant for me and I should sit and concentrate upon my study, I have become the sports captain of the same school.
Oh.
And now same school, right. then I very next year I changed to CBSE school. I'm presently at CBSE school, but still that school teachers, I got a special message from the principal of the school, and now they are eagerly waiting for me to come back to the school as a chief guest. So I would say, just believe in yourself and things will happen good, and finger crossed everything will get well soon and this COVID will also go back very soon.
Yeah, congratulations to you, Palak, that you have achieved so much and you have come so far in your career that from that school, so you which about which you were telling that you were told by your PT teacher that sports is not meant for you, and you came all way to becoming like national pride. So I want to ask you that one thing, if I tell you that you have to tell one thing to all those who have treated you unfairly, like those that PT teacher or any other person in your life who has treated you unfairly. So what would you tell them, that one thing?
Okay, when these things happened with me in my school life, at that moment when I used to come back to my home, I used to sit aside and I used to think that I will do something and then I will react this way and I'll go back to the school and I'll show the teachers and everything. I made up a lot of plans at that moment, I would say, but now since I am a bit grown up now, I think that was a very kiddish one plan. So now I would say, I don't want to say anything. I think so sharing up of my links cheering up of my teammates is something that's enough. So sometimes there is no action, there are no words required. As actions speak louder than words. So I think so that's enough.
That was a really, you know, that was a really mature answer by you. So other thing which I want to ask is one thing you would like to tell to your juniors or any future talents of this country in your category or in any other sport?
Okay. The one thing I think so, what I believe in is that we all need to believe in ourselves first. And that is the best thing, because if you believe in yourself, you can do anything, because there is nothing that's impossible. If you are confident of it, of choosing the path, you think you can excel in the way, in whichever field you wish to. I think so. You just need to have faith in yourself first. If you will have faith in yourself, the people around you will also start getting, you know, trust upon you and trust upon your ambitions and dreams. Because like when I thought of badminton, my parents, my family, they didn't took me seriously, because when I kept on insisting them that I wish to start, like I miss Didi pad gayi thi ki I wish to, then they also see something in me. They saw something that she's like usse subah uthti ek cheez yaad aa rahi hai, raat ko sote hue is samay bhi ek hi cheez yaad aa rahi hai, so let us try ki kya hai, nahi to humare ko saans nahi lene degi. Now she has thought something, so let's give a try in this field also. Zyada se zyada kya hoga, nahi hoga, have a try. So yeah, that was something that I think so everyone needs to believe, as that will also start getting pushing you. Key to show that it's not because for parents, I think so it's also right from their perspective also, because kids are like, aaj hum badminton khelenge, kal de wo bolte hum cricket khelenge. So because that state of age, that state of mind is something like that, which is quite immature. And it's like ki aaj uske dost ne aaj table tennis khela hai to main bhi table tennis khelne jaunga, usne chhod diya wo nahi aa rahi meri friend to main bhi nahi jaunga. So this is something because of which parents don't take these things seriously, but the moment you will show your express your attachment towards that specific field, I think they will understand you, and that is a way that you will find up. Because when parents and when family supports you, that support becomes unconditional, and then you get more strength of staying outdoors. Because since the moment I left my house, now then my parents never asked me like, lockdown ho raha hai tum ghar aaogi, because they are very clear. Here they ask me like, hum aa jate hain or you can come. But this time when the lockdown happened, they don't care. They wo bhi seekh gaye hain ki kuch farak nahi padega bolne ka. So now they never ask me when you are planning to come home. So they are okay ki training ho gaya, achha ho gaya, okay ab tum kya kare. So that is the topic. They also never ask ki, they never show their emotions that hume yaad aa rahi hai and all. Neither do I. So the things are going good this way.
So to add to Palak's point, for our listeners who are parents, I would I'm a sportsman myself. I've been also a badminton parent. So I'll highly recommend to put your children or your kids in any sports, because what sports teaches us can't be education can't teach us, because the discipline which we get in sports, also the confidence and other game tactics, just make us mentally strong, right? So I'll just highly recommend every parent who is listening to us that they should definitely put their children in sports, and this is the way how we could produce other many more Palak Kohlis from India. So Palak Kohli, that was end of our podcast. I must say that you were fantastic in our podcast. You just gave all the answers very maturely, and we wish you a great luck for Paralympics as well. We want to see you on podium actually, and we want to celebrate with you when you come back to India. and God bless you. Wish you a lot of luck and thanks for joining podcast by Tirang Sports.
Thank you so much for having me here.